I will not die, the resurrection. I'm picking a fight with the devil. Amen. I'm going to pick a fight with him. I'm letting him know you ain't getting nothing like you got last year, the year before. Nothing. Nothing. You ain't going to get my emotions. You ain't going to get my thoughts like you used to get them. You ain't going to get my time like you used to get them. You ain't getting nothing like you used to. Welcome to World Conquerors Church, the place where you discover who you were born to be. My name is Pastor Darren Barron, and we are in a praise party, as you can see. Amen. Clearly, we have come on a little bit tardy, but we didn't start tardy. Amen. We actually started a little bit different with our men coming together, surrounding around our young men with just prayer. We were about to just let that be praise and worship. You got to be here to see it and be here in the atmosphere. But if you're not able, of course, as you're not able to be here, we want to make sure that you're able to peer in and be a part of this worship experience. At this time, we have a special thing that we're about to do. We're about to bring up the Hatchells, and they are going to move us in the next part of the service in doing a survey. It has been on my heart to do a survey and to gather information. And you at home, you're able to be a part of it as well. So make sure that you're going to need your phones, because we're doing this. It's going to be all online. So you're going to need your phone. So if you're watching us, I don't know how you're watching us, on your phone or whatever. You need your phones, right? You do need your phones, right? So you do need your phones. I'm about to get mine. And we'll take our survey online. And the survey will give us information on how we're able to effectively minister to you throughout the year. So we are looking forward to this part of the service as we gather this information. Anybody excited about Jesus in the building? Amen. Amen. Well, without further ado, let us bring up Jeffrey David and Wendy Shotlow Hatchell. Amen. Let's give them a praise.
Hallelujah.
I'm still
push it on, sweetheart.
Still a little on the praise and worship. It's still bubbling up on the inside of me. And all three of the songs that they sang was just beautiful. Could we give a round of applause for our praise and worship team? We appreciate you. Thank you. Thank you. You know, sometimes certain songs, you know, I like the fast ones and I like the slow ones, but sometimes the slow ones, I like to close my eyes.
Yeah.
And, you know, sometimes you like to really get into it. And I'm like, I got to be careful, because when I close my eyes, I get into it. Sometimes you open your eyes, you're like, why am I on the floor way in a corner? You know what I mean? When you really get into a praise and worship.
Like, I was fighting. Like, I was, like, moving. I was like, well, I hope I'm moving appropriately, because my moves was just shifting and changing with the lyrics. But, love that praise and worship.
Yes.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. We loved it. So we are here because we are going to be leading an effort for us to do a survey. So how many of you recall over the last several weeks, and even maybe a month or so, we had a couple videos that we showed with Pastor and myself, and we were talking about we're going to be doing a survey. We did a video talking about the survey. You guys remember that?
Yeah.
And we were talking about it because we wanted everyone to start to think about their thoughts, to take it serious. So,
right.
And this is that day. And the way it's going to start, we're going to start it with more, I'll call them lighter questions, just to kind of get everybody warmed up and in the mood. But the questions are going to be more of a way of reinforcing some of the messages and some of the things that we heard.
It'll also be an opportunity to see if you were actually digesting the word from 2022, or just from any period of your time here at WCC. So it's a little light. It could be light unless you're competitive. If you get competitive, it can be a little heavy.
Yeah. So the first few questions are fun. And then at the conclusion, there are about five of them, and then at the conclusion of that, we're just going to ask whether you're in person or if you're online, and then we're going to ask just one question, and I'll let you know what it is. It's the bottom line question is, what is the biggest challenge that's on your hearts and minds? And we want you to put that in. You get 250 characters, but you'll have an opportunity of sharing that. So that's where we're going.
Right. And so the question again is, your biggest challenge that you are facing that you want pastor or the church to be helping you through, praying you through, coming in agreement with ministry. You in to yeah. be delivered. And so the question will have a little more context to it, but it is short. And I just wanted to share that we called it like the biggest challenge survey, and challenge not in that it is something that is difficult and that is hard, but it's an opportunity. I kind of went back to Pastor's message where he said the purpose of the challenge. What is the purpose of the challenge for believers? And if you look in James 1, 2 through 4, the first thing it says is to consider the challenge a gift,
yes.
right? To consider it joy to be in the challenge. And then as you go through this survey, Pastor's other message was to change your mindset. Your mind, your perception of how you see a thing is how you're going to go into that challenge. And so I just think it is just God working through Pastor, of course. And him disseminating that word to us is how we're going to be able to come together collectively to pray for one another, to be in worship with one another through what we know that is being a challenge for you.
So let's go to it.
Yes.
So this is going to be online, and it's going to be on the screen. So everyone will leverage that.
Yeah. So if you go to the next slide, you will see there are two options for you to participate in the survey today. So if you are online or if you're at home or wherever you may be, you can either scan the QR code that you see on the screen right now, or you can go to menti.com. So there's a link if you can see it. I have my new glasses on, and they are very large, and I should be able to see all the way over there, but it is www.menti.com, and there is a code.
menti.com.
Right. I'm hopeful that the QR code will work, but again, if it does not, you will be able to go on that website, and then you will enter a code, which you see before you on the screen. The code is 7530138. Once you enter that code, we're going to come off screen because it's not about us. It's about you now having a little bit of a good time before you get into the survey. And so we'll be showing you a screen that will display the survey.
So it's not started. We're about to start it. So you may see something that says it hasn't started yet. So that means you are at the right place.
It says join another clear.
No, you're good. So you're at the right place. Yes, you are at the right place.
So if you have gone ahead and you're one of those competitive people and you want to get to the survey faster than anybody else and you're already on that page, it will tell you slow your roll. We will get there in a moment. And once we start the survey, then you will be able to access it.
Yeah, you'll see it. But that means you're at a good place if that's what you see on your screen, on your phone. Say it again, First Lady. Yes, that's it. That's it. Yeah. Thank you. You are at the right place.
You are at the right place.
You are at the right place. So, everybody good?
Yeah.
So all right. Everyone is good.
Okay.
There are no prizes we'll be given at the end of this.
we got a prize.
We're going to pray for you.
I got $10 in my pocket.
Okay, I thought that was mine.
I put $10 in my pocket.
All right. So,
just to have a little fun with the in-person audience.
All right.
You'll see what we mean, but let's just
we will take the survey, so we're moving over to where our staff pastor Ananda is, because we're going to go onto the website and we're going to display the survey for you. So see you back in a minute, all right? Or maybe you won't see me in a minute. You might. The next people you see after the survey will be our pastor and our First Lady, Monique Barron.
So I'm going to stand here so you can help.
I'm going to go.
You like her? What about mine? I got new glasses too. that's all I have in my pocket. I should have grabbed more, but I'm glad I grabbed that. But yeah, I got new glasses too, but I guess nobody noticed my new frames. I've been watching Pastor. It seems like he got a new set of frames every time he get up. That's why I'm like, all right, I gotta switch it up. I gotta get something different. So we got our eye exam, then we got the new prescriptions. All right, let me make sure they're good. Yeah, she's about to turn it on. I'm off the camera. Oh. So. Yeah, they're looking at the screen. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. Oh, you can. Oh, okay. All right, so we are, just so everyone knows what we're doing, if you're watching online, we are about to activate the survey. So you can take it shortly. And Wendy's going to let me know when she is there. It has the date. It has today's date. So she started it. It has the date. You put the one with the today's date, right? Okay. All right. So it looks like you should be on the first question right now. Yeah, so I'm gonna. What was WCC's theme for 2022? So everybody with us for the next question? All right, so question 2 of 5, it says, answer fast to get more points. What is WCC's mantra? Is it WCC is the smallest, biggest church in the world? Is it build the people, impact the community, reach the world? Everybody needs a pastor, or where you discover who you were born to be? Yes. All right, get ready for the third question. Get ready for the question number 3. What topic did Pastor Darren Barron speak on most in 2022? The reality of governing myself, I am better because of the challenge, God made a choice to choose you, how do I receive inward peace? Loading results. All right, question number four is, which is the correct flow from Pastor Darren Barron's messages in 2022? Choice, challenge, change, challenge, change, choice, or change, choice, challenge? All right. Okay. Here's question 5 of 5. This is it for this quiz. Last question for this quiz. Based on the first Bible study of this year, which is just this Thursday, Pastor Darren and First Lady would like for all of WCC to do what in 2023? You see the last one? What you guys preached on at Bible study. What you want, it, we passed it. You got it? You missed it? You didn't see it? So the last question was, what, and it had, well, Wendy can tell us, but it had four different, what was the last question?
Mike. The last question was, what did you guys instruct, or what did you ask us to do
for 2023.
So if you were not trying to answer the question first and fast and you read through everything, you would have seen that it was everything that you guys had asked us to do, right?
There was one question that you simply said, I don't know. At least 10%. It was apply
Romans
12, 1 and 2, and apply Ephesians 6 and 18.
And so it was all the above, all the above.
Yeah.
That's okay. And so because I don't know was included in that, it's okay because we got you guys' attention. So now you're paying attention.
Yeah.
But and now when this last question.
It was directly from Bible study.
Yes. If you paid attention, if you didn't listen to the message, then you probably said, I don't know. I know who said I don't know, but we're going to see. Because online right now, Aninda led the leaderboard. So she is paying attention. She was over here like, I got to get back. I got to get
it. So the elders can't win. The elders can't win because they had a preview. Yeah.
Okay.
But who outside of the elders?
All right. Let me move. Give me a second.
The elders can't.
This is going to be.
The elders can't.
Here's a question because we're going to move on because we're in service. Is where you're taking the survey from.
So we just want to know if you are here in person, you click that. If you're here in a sanctuary, if you are watching online, if you're watching through YouTube, click that one. If you're watching on Facebook Live, click that one. If you're watching through our website, Vimeo, click that one. And if anything else, click that one. Where are you taking the survey from?
And we're going to give people time, but we are seeing that the majority of our participants today are in person. Hint, hint, maybe you need to be in person next Sunday.
Mm-hmm.
But if not, okay, wait a minute. We got some folks that are on Facebook Live. We got some on YouTube.
All right.
We got some people who left the survey and came back because they was Googling the answers. We don't know. That's okay. Whatever you have to do to get that right answer is what's important. So what we're going to ask you to do next is to really clear your hearts and minds as you answer this last question. It is what Pastor and Elder David talked about, which is, what is the biggest challenge that you might be facing in 2023 that you would like us to come in agreement with you on for deliverance, for guidance, for wisdom, for God to open up a new thing for you in that? And so that is going to be the next question. Our minister of music is going to give us something that we can think to. And here we go.
So this is strictly fill in the blank.
It is a free form area, or it should be, for you all to fill in. What's the character limitation?
250. So that's a lot.
So if you over 250, come see me. We can work it out.
other thing I'll just mention as you are wrapping up, for those of you who were not able for whatever reason to go through this survey, you are welcome to go to our website, worldconquerschurch.org, and go to our prayer request, and you may put in your comments there in terms of the challenges and what you would like to be pastored on. So you may also enter it there at any time.
And I'm going to give it 30 more seconds before we transition. And the last thing that we will say before you see the next beautiful smiling faces before you is just know that those prayers, those requests that you placed in the freeform area are things that are going back to the leadership of World Conquerors Church. And it won't necessarily be a message that pastor is teaching, but it'll be something that is across all of the different platforms of learning and development that WCC has, right? So it could be pastor, yes, teaching a message or a first lady, but it could also be a Bible study, a growth group, a life group, that you will start to hear and see the things that you are believing God to help you through and change. You'll start to see those things. So we are, I think we're good, and we're going to bring up our pastor, Darren Barron, and first lady. Maybe not first lady, but her husband, who is the pastor of the church, is before you.
Yeah. Thank you for those of you watching to have this patience with us as we take this survey. Really important for us to make sure that we consider you all before we move forward. I have a couple of things before we start. First, in terms of an announcement, first we have Jasmine. You want to come up first and give your announcement? Jazzy Jazz, y'all. One
everyone.
And only.
I'll be very brief. In honor of the Dr. King Day of Service on Monday, January 16th, we will be meeting as a church and community at Lake Merritt United Methodist Church to pass out lunches to those that are in encampments and elsewhere around Lake Merritt, just to really speak to people in our community and to lend a helping hand. So if you're interested in doing that, please reach out to me. You can email me at jbraxton11@gmail.com, or just let me know after service if you're here. And then I'll sign us up collectively. We can all do that on Monday the 16th. Please let me know by Wednesday at 5 p.m. if you are coming. And again, that's in honor of Dr. King Day. And it's on Monday the 16th from 2 to approximately 4 o'clock. Thanks. Yes. Thank you for that question. So to clarify, the meals and everything are already there at the site, and we'll just be putting things together kind of like an assembly line. And once the packages are ready, then we're going to distribute those. So you don't have to bring anything. But in the future, we are looking into how we as a church can also do something similar, in that we'll all bring together toiletries or other items to distribute to people that are unhoused in the community. And another future project will be a literary project where we can collect books and distribute them either to the juvenile halls or to the prison system, just to make sure these people know that we are thinking of them, that they are not like outside of like the system or outside of this community. We definitely want to focus on economic empowerment and making sure that our community is taken care of, essentially. So look out for those announcements too. Thank you.
Amen. A lot of things coming up. Because back in the day, we'd make our own peanut butter and jelly sandwich. We say it'd be the Barons bring 10, 20, Mitchells y'all bring whatever, make our own bologna sandwich. I guess I can't ever forget the time when we went out that time and that dude told Dez, he said, I don't want no peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Dez told him, beggars can't be choosers. You better eat the sandwich. Huh? They had rotisserie chicken sandwiches. Okay. Well, you're eating good here in the Bay, amen. So yeah, we thank God for that, of course. we are all about building people, impacting the community, and reaching the world. And we're trying to grow back into these disciplines as well. Amen. Well, I mean, we're, of course, we're always building, just coming to church, hearing the word, exercising the word is building. But making sure that we make impact in the community. I'm trying to do more of like hands-on, like what we did this in the end of last year, taking and really taking a person's life and making a difference to it. That's what I'm personally trying to work on. And plus these things always. Anybody ever been hungry here? Okay, hangry? So then you can imagine somebody giving you some food when you don't know where it's coming from, it can make a difference. Some ministries though are really, and you'll hear me talk about it in a minute, some ministries are really built for that kind of thing. I'm looking for you all to raise up what you love to do. I don't want to just, so this is something, Jasmine is going to do this no matter if y'all join her or not. And I'm looking for everyone to raise up. This needs to become your ministry. Amen? One of the things that I think that I say an Ananda or a Chris will love, this year, I want us as a church to get closer, 10%. I want us to be closer. Thank you very much, amen. And everybody's scared of that because closer means that you know more of me and you may be up in my business. We can't be who we're about to come if we don't go closer. And so I'm working on us growing closer, amen? And I know a lot of times it's, you know, you think just because somebody loves Jesus, it don't mean that they love you. They're trying to learn how to love Jesus, to understand to love you. Amen. All right. Next announcement is our fast. Everybody ready for our fast for this year? Not everybody. Like, well, what day is it? I can't see that. It's the last 3 days. Our fast this year is the last 3 days in January, February, and March. Yes, I know in February we'll start the fast on my birthday. No better time to start it, amen? I need a rebirth anyway. So, last 3 days of January, February, and March. I mean, that is so small. Goodness. All right, everybody have that. Next week, hear the announcement. We'll be adding something onto that and what we will be doing. I just haven't checked with everyone to make sure that we're going to do that. But we will be doing our fast, and there's a reason why we're doing it like this. What I will be asking for is that we all, on these 3 days, not, of course, you're eating and all of that, but also any television or any social media unnecessary. Some of you work on social media or whatever, that's fine. I'm talking about unnecessary social media. I see a lot of you all, I know in my household, especially the young folks, they'll sit and watch TV and the phone all at the same time. What I like for the young folks to do, I like for them to read up on what that does to a brain and a mind. And again, I think if you really study that, you'll discover that a lot of mental illness is coming from that. There used to be a day where we used to watch TV and you had to get the rabbit ears just to watch one screen. Now screens are flashing everywhere. I'm trying to watch TV, but then they got down at the bottom as a ticker also. Which one am I supposed to do? I'm not going to lecture you all on that. Y'all read that yourself. What if you take 3 days to step away from these apparatuses? That's all I'm saying. Do you. We're going to take 3 days in the month for the first quarter of the year. And this is all connecting into something. Everybody good with that? All right. Would you all give me 28 minutes of your time? Father, we thank you, Lord, for the word that is about to come forward. We believe that as this word is being opened up, that our hearts is being opened up also, and that we believe it will move the needle in our life, Lord, that as we are blessed and we know this, that we'll be a blessing unto someone else. We thank you, Lord, for giving us this day. We count it to be our daily bread, Father. And as we take eat of this day, Lord, we will nourish someone else. We thank you. We love you. We give you glory, honor, and we give you all of the praise. Does someone say amen? Amen. Before we go, I want to give God thanks for the Hatchels finally getting this thing up and going. Amen. Wasn't that a lot to do that? Dang. I mean, there's so many different things from the storm to you know, all kind of stuff just to get that going. But did it look like it turned out good? It did? Amen. So, amen. So we'll see from that. And we'll be doing more because we want to make sure that we communicate not only with our in-person audience, but those that are watching us online as well. What I'd like to discuss with you just for a few moments, and I will be keeping my time, is 10 simple steps in making wise decisions. 10 simple steps in making wise decisions. I've really discovered that, man, people make some of the most challenging decisions, wanting one thing, but doing another. Of course, because of time, you know I ain't getting through all. I have to come back next week, right? But we'll get through a few. We'll get through a few. I have clearly discovered that it is through my decision making, intentional decision making, that has caused a basic level, I don't want to call it success, but at least peace, whatever the case may be, balance. And so that's why before I make a decision, the environment for me has to be correct and right. And so I'm still in it right now. As I'm coming up with the vision of the church, I haven't even really unveiled it fully yet because I don't make a decision when things are volatile or when things are not ideal. So before I even go there, we'll deal with this later. Before I even go there, because you have to define the type of environment you're able to make the optimum decisions in. And all of us can deal with things at different levels. The level of pressure on me may be too much for you. The level, or it may be like that's nothing to me. But you have to figure that out for yourself. But whatever you do, you have to make sure before you make a decision that, and watch this, because this is connected to what we talked about last year. It's connected, a decision is connected to choice. So, we know, what do we know? We know when we come closer to God, there's going to be some challenges. Why? There will be challenges simply because we're used to living in the flesh. And as we come to a God that is holy, requesting for us to do holy things, we inadvertently have been living unholy lives. The Bible tells us we were all born into sin. So that means God is calling for us to do something different, and that means there's going to be a challenge. Next, there's going to be a request for change. That is difficult, especially when the way you've been living has now taken root in how you think. Because now you think there's nothing wrong with the way I live. It's just the way it is. You haven't even consulted God yet. God is wrong before you can even get started. And so you never, and now you have to reduce God and him even being your creator. So God's no longer my creator anymore. Or if God is my creator, I'm still making decisions on how I should run my life, and I don't have no idea of how God said I should run my life. But if you ever subscribe to say, you know what? What does God have to say? It will require change. Next, what we're talking about, because we start this new year, choices. The choices you make, you cannot say it's going to be a new year and there's not a new you. And now you have to figure out how to make choices. Let me tell you this. Monique and I are in kind of a few different conversations. We had one today just talking about love today. I'm listening to a message, and I hear something from it, and it's like, whoa, I've never heard it that way before. And as I heard it, I brought it up to Monique, and we start talking, and I'm still in a place of processing what I heard. If I didn't hear that, I'm going to love or do things in the way of how I think it should be done, and I'm expecting an optimum result back. If I don't get an optimal result back, I will give up on love and define it and just do it the way I think it should be done. Now I've been given new information, which is now challenging me, causing me to change, and now I have to make a choice on what I receive. Most people don't go through those steps and do that. You stay the same. And now people don't even know. We have this situation where, you know, young man falls on the football field and everybody erupts in prayer. But most people don't know that effectively to pray, God will come and he will say, okay, that's good. The nation sees that prayer is important because the nation also took prayer out of schools. And so now we're trying to raise it up again. But today, the sad part is the level of prayer, people are so ignorant in it. And who are you praying to? You sent a wonderful article from the Wall Street Journal. He wrote that thing beautifully in the way of, look up the Wall Street Journal. I mean, if you want to send it up to the church, that's fine. Give it to Tom. You can send it to the men or whatever. But I guess he's a believer. Is he a believer? David, is he a believer? He tried to act like he was. And I loved how he approached it, but here goes the point. He tried to approach it because, no, he said he was a Protestant. He made that point that he was Protestant, but he played around with this, and he stayed on this line of most people are unbelievers. So it was very interesting. And then even up to say that, I mean, people are praying to something they don't even know what they're praying to. Almost prayer has been denoted as something of weakness. But now prayer has erupted, people are coming, but here's what's so scary. What's elementary to maybe you or I is like everything to someone else. And then still maintaining ignorance in terms of we don't know who really the healer is. We just all got together and we just prayed. It matters who you're praying to. And this is not to say to bring up an argument or anything, but this is for what I'm, you know, here to do is to bring correction. And that's why I said it's 10 simple steps in making wise decisions. So it's not wise walking around, and this is something added on there. It's not wise walking around just being ignorant just because you're just being ignorant. It's not wise to walk around being challenged and doing nothing about it, not changing, not wise, but saying Happy New Year. Making choices that has brought you to a place to where you really, if you ask yourself, am I happy? I'm happy, but you're not happy, really. It's not wise. So we're going to work to try to get you on the pathway to helping you make some wise decisions. Somebody say, I'm encouraged because of my choices. Now, let me tell you this. The reason why that's there is because no matter what position I'm in, and right now, when Monday hits, I get to live in it, I got some big decisions to make. And sometimes, does anybody just need a rest? Can you just leave me alone until the day comes? I don't want to talk about Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. I don't want to even deal with that. Now, I got some mind. What encourages me is when I know that I'll be making choices that's connected to one that can do something about it. If I didn't have that, I get why people are so where they are. It's too much for me. I got to know there's a God. Or what are we doing? I just, you know, it's too much. Then I go into thinking about, wow, my mom passed away a year ago this month. Wow, 2 years ago, my father-in-law passed away at the same time. See, then all these other thoughts start coming on you to compound, you know. Then I'm thinking, wow, I got to deal with my father now dealing with that stuff and all of that stuff. Wow, I got to deal with, you know, people not coming to church or participating or, you know, trying to grow or people are attracting. Wow. See, there's so many things to sit and to be negative about. It's on and on. If I didn't know, I got to find something that encourages me, because I got to get ready to make a choice, and I'm going to make a choice to have joy instead of all this other kind of stuff. I'm going to make a choice to have it, because it's been good. Somebody said, I'm going to make a choice to have joy. Because let me tell you something. The world we live in now is not going to be coming up with just joy. I mean, I've been living here years. I've never seen it rain like I've seen it rain in these upcoming years, these weeks. Even last year. I mean, have anybody ever seen it rain like this to the level that it has been, to this level? I mean, you've seen it? Like this? El Nino, yeah. Well, somebody should come to my house. Maybe just, I'm talking about directly at my house. I mean, I thank God I got my house redone. The wind was blowing at some point, huh? I'm just saying, you know, okay. But are these not, what is it going to take? El Nino, El Paco, El Huo. What is it going to take for us to El Waco? This is crazy. I mean, just how stuff is happening, and we are desensitized to all of it. We are desensitized. These high extremes, drought, too much water. I got to make me some wise decisions, and while I'm making them, I need to stay in a place of encouragement through my choices. Amen? Let's hit number one. Be very clear about who your real guide is. Whoever has control of your heart has control over you. Now, this is something even when I was working. Because I've worked in tumultuous places, and it's like, this is how you keep your professionalism. I read an article the other day about where are all the professionals? Because in this day and age, I guess new workers expect things that when I was coming up working, you went to work. I mean, Randall, and praise God, Randall back there, my grandson, and he got paid time off. He does. I didn't have no paid time off. I had to take time off to go and bond with my children. They have it, and that's good. I mean, that's good. We just didn't have that. But there are certain people that have expectations of a place. Watch this. You have an expectation of your workplace, but that costs money to come in to make sure that something that you're not producing anything, yet you still want to get paid for, yet you want prices to go down. I'm not complaining about it. I'm just saying understand the mathematics and the economics of it all. Because you can't expect things to go down while somebody is not at work yet getting paid for it. And as a, you know, when you're a business owner, like, I don't think I've ever not paid anyone even when they didn't work. I still paid them. But I expect them to do the work at some point. All right. I'm trying to tell you because this will help you everywhere you go. School, this will help you everywhere you go. Be clear about who your real guide is, because let me tell you something. Now, parents, you have children. Who is guiding your children? Because you can barely get to them, but who's guiding them then? What friend are they listening to the most? What music are they listening to? What's impacting them the most? I know you may be in their ear, but who are they listening to, following the most? Who are you listening to and following the most? Whoever has control of your heart has control over you. Let me start from Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. I'm going to start down there first, and we'll work our way back up to Proverbs chapter 3. Notice most of my scriptures are going to be and come from Proverbs. It is the wisdom chapter or book of the Bible. I want you to also, we'll deal with this later, about wisdom being connected to a woman. You ain't gonna wanna miss that when I talk about that. Because this whole, calm down, Darren, this whole thought about God being a woman is not true. So those of you that's doing that, stop it. It's not true, it has no, and we'll talk about truth and facts in a minute. It's not true. But what is true, wisdom was there with God to make the world. And wisdom is noted in a female sense. See, when you don't know even from male and female, because too many males have done a bad job in supporting females and then, you know, and when you don't know the truth, you'll say anything. Even up to try to make God a female. And watch this. If males didn't do such a bad job, there wouldn't be a problem of God being a male. If males didn't do a bad job. My wife don't have a problem with Darren being the head of the house because I'm not doing a bad job there. So I'm trying to get in because some of you had bad experiences with a male. So if God is a male and I had a bad experience with a male, then I can't let God be that. I'm already off as I'm praying or I'm believing hopefully in something or now I believe in none of that. But can we get to the place where we first at least know what the truth is? Now, everybody got that. So Proverbs 4:23 says, guard your heart above all else. Do what? So that is, so listen, so before you start your year good, guard your heart above all else. Before you even get going, you better get guard your heart because now you've already lived many years and maybe didn't consider guarding your heart. So now you have to understand what is the contents that is in your heart because out of your heart, you'll see this later, flows the issues of life. So if I'm going to really have a consistent flow of peace, a consistent flow of joy, we didn't see peace and joy doesn't mean that you always have to be happy. There will be things that will happen in your life, and this does not make me happy, but I still have a peace. I still have joy. And when you can't understand the difference, that's why people say, I don't want to live anymore. So guard your heart above all else. Say that with me. Guard your heart above all else. Make it personal. Guard my heart above all else. And then watch what it says. For or because it determines the course of your life. I can stop right now, and this is something to think about because before you go forward, and when we talk about the course of your life, and again, I'm just telling you personally, I know this already. I've been doing this. I'm trying to take a step back, and I'm literally, as we speak right now, I'm doing this for my own life. I'm stopping some things, and I'm saying, all right, listen, what course do I want to go on? So then you take all the areas of your life, your health, your family, your whatever, take all the areas of your life and figure out what course you're going to take. Now, mostly in life, a course is not going to be a straight line. A course is going to be something where it's going to be some bumpy roads, some potholes, some ramps. It's going to be a lot of different things, right? And so the scripture's telling me to determine how, so you can know what tires to put on this day, you better get your heart right. Because otherwise, you'll be going out on run flat tires when you need some big tires to go across this muddy road that you're about to go over. Remember, God never promises that you're not going to have any challenges or it's not going to be but God says, if your heart's right, I will help you to go through this particular course in your life. Guard your heart above all else. So that means before you do anything else, guard your heart. Before you do anything else, everybody in the house, how's your heart? Here's what they're going to say. What you mean? What you mean? I mean, how are you really doing? Check everybody's heart out. Now, go up to Proverbs 3. And we see here, it says, my son, be my daughter. It's both ways in that. Do not forget my teaching. So God is coming straight up. Now, again, I'm going real slow here, y'all. God is saying, some of y'all could just rattle this off. But we can rattle it off, but we can't live it off. Do not forget my teaching. So he makes the assumption that you already got it the first time. This is in the Old Testament. And the New Testament, he gives you the reason why. Jesus himself says, because whatever word you receive that's according to the kingdom, the enemy has the ability to steal it. The revelation is not here yet. So he says, do not forget my teaching. Do not what? Yeah, do not forget my teaching. 2023, God says, my teaching is there. I'm trying to tell you what's going on. I'm trying to tell you what's happening. Don't forget my teaching. I love what the Hatchels did in bringing us in remembrance and all the things that we did for this year. Why? Because you shouldn't be forgetting these things. What would make me say something and preach almost the same message the whole year? Because I don't want you to forget it. Something is coming and you need to be prepared for it. Don't forget my teaching, comma. It says, but keep my commands in your heart. Notice there's two things there. Same sentence, but two things. Because God is not talking to a person here that is just a lightweight person in him. He's talking to someone who has the potential to be a believer. Because there are people, watch this, that know his commands and haven't forgotten them, but they don't do them for nothing. There's a difference from a hearer and a doer. So this is cleaned up in the New Testament. Just don't be a hearer of the word, but a what? A doer. Why? Because we see here, we see in the scripture, we see that the rich young ruler came up and says, I already know everything you said. And then he goes on and says, I've done them all. This is Old Testament, New Testament. Somebody says, oh, I know all this. He said, okay, I ain't forgot nothing he said. So Jesus came up and he talks about it. Am I going too deep a little bit? Because I'm trying not to go deep. He says, a new commandment. This is scripture. A new commandment I've given you. And what was it? To love one another. To love one another. So watch this. Why does it say new commandment? Because they already thought, all the religious folks thought they already knew everything else. We already know. So Jesus says, a new commandment I give you. What's that? To love one another. Well, what do you mean? Yeah, y'all know how to sacrifice goats. I got it. Yeah, y'all know how to pray. Y'all know how to fast. Yeah, y'all know how to do all of that, but what y'all can't seem to do is love one another. Well, why couldn't they? Because love hadn't died on the cross yet. They didn't have a pathway to it yet, and they didn't even know. Here is an insight to that. Don't y'all love the word? See if you ever really just get into the word and you see it. But keep my commandments, watch this, in your heart. Because one day you're going to have the activator to the information. Yes, I got the word, but I don't know how to activate it yet. Now, I don't want to make it because some people's like, oh, man. That's what I'm saying. I don't like going to church, man. It make it too hard, too difficult. Well, it was difficult getting to where you are now. So it's going to be somewhat of a mental challenge to unravel you to be able to get the fullness of the promises of God. It says, for they will, watch this, for they will prolong your life many years, bring you peace. It says, watch this, doing this will not just get, you already have it, it will bring you peace and prosperity. And we're not talking about just with money and stuff. Prosperity means whole life. Let love and faithfulness never leave you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart, that you will win favor and a good name in the sight of God and man. And it goes and it says this. Trust in the Lord with all your heart. It says two things here. So trust in the Lord with what? Then it says, and as a conjunction. Then it says what? So here's the thing. God is already saying, because remember, be very clear about who your guide is. God is already telling you, you have been your guide too much. First, he's saying, trust in me. Let me be your guide. Then he says, because you need help, and you keep trying to do it on your own. Y'all see that? So trust in the Lord with all your heart. Everybody know that scripture. But don't lean on your own understanding. What did you do in 2022? You leaned too many times on your own understanding. Isn't that what you did? Yeah. If I go down, in all your ways, submit to him, and he will make your path straight. So everybody want their path straight, but you didn't submit to him. Then he says, do not be wise in your own eyes. So it comes right back again. Whoever has control of your heart has control over you. Because too many of us, and we get frustrated. Well, who else am I supposed to trust then? God said, trust in him. What does that look like? What does that mean? We stay in this place of trying to make God so mysterious and so, I'm going to demystify it. I want to close, but it's 1 o'clock, and I have a close for y'all and everything. But I'm going to keep to my word, and I'm going to stop right here. We only made it to one slide. But y'all got one. Be very clear. And this could take you a week to do. Be very clear about who your real guide is. Whoever has control of your heart has control over you. And if you can get this right, you can at least start off very strong. You hear what I'm saying? Very, very strong. And that's what I'm personally trying to do. I'm not trying to let any idiots get in the way of my thoughts or my attitude. I'm not trying to let any people, persons, things, stuff get in the way of what I have to do for 2023. Purposefully, I'm grabbing this season, this moment, and you all are coming with me. And we declare we win. Amen? Amen, amen. Y'all going to come back next week? Amen. Listen, if you are watching us, hopefully this is an adequate opening for your new year. I have so much more to share with you, and I want you to be a part of what we have to share. Listen, one of the things is I pray that this has been good enough for you to where you want to make sure that you take care of this ministry. If you like to give, there's many ways that you're able to give. I don't know if it's up on the screens and all of that. Not on the screens yet. But you can give by Cash App. You can log into World Conquerors Church, and you can see all the different ways to give. This is a ministry that is good ground for sure. I was just looking over just some of the financials over the past several years, and I'm just saying we serve an awesome God for sure. We serve an awesome God. And I'm looking for God to do greater and better than ever he has before. And God has done, I'm just in awe of God and what he has done. But we need partners like you to maintain your support in this ministry so we can do all of the things that we do in our mission to build people, families. And here's another thing. I really will be concentrating on families this year. I'm concentrating on families this year. We need to make family units strong. stronger. Amen. Impact the community. I think that once family units are stronger, we need to get out of our silos, out of our small groups, and go impact the community. We need to be a voice in the community. Thus, then we will reach the world. Then whatever we do will have impact in the world of what we do. Those of you that take care of this ministry, you help us to do that. And I want to thank, let me just stop right here. Everybody that helps to take care of this ministry, I just want to thank you. Amen. Give yourselves right now even a round of applause that helped to take care of this ministry. I'm proud to say that people live because of this ministry. I'm proud to say people eat and people are doing well because of this ministry. And I'm so thankful and I'm so proud of that. You like to give, of course, many different ways to do so. We ask that you do that. Of course, if you are a part of this ministry and you'd like to give your tithe and your offering, please do that. Amen. That is bringing forth a tenth of your income at the very least. I forgot what I give. Over 30% of my income comes to the ministry, for sure. It may even be 40% comes to the ministry. But the very minimum is 10%. Governments don't trust us. They take it out on the top. They don't trust you to bring it. God says, I want this to be something that is in your heart. So there's an exchange where you see as you come and give, that it shall be given. Pressed down, shaken together, good measure, running over. God says, well, I have someone come and give to you. If you're in the building now, if you need an envelope, please raise your hand and they'll come and bring an envelope to you. If you're watching me, of course, you can't get an envelope there. Well, maybe you do. Some do, and they mail it in. You can go ahead and mail that in to the P.O. box that is shown. Again, I want to make sure we are going to bring in more this year than we have ever brought. So I'm even getting a spreadsheet so I can see it. We're going to do better than we've ever done before. If not you, someone else. I don't care if y'all got to go down there and play that lotto right now. Amen. Is that what you do? Do what you got to do. Amen. First lady said, no, don't do that. Don't do that. And I don't know if that's going to happen that way, because I think God says, I'm trying to show you that I can do it through you. Listen to me. I'm trying to show you I can do it through you. But God, I made less. God said, that's why you're going to know that it was me. You know what I'm saying? We have less in so many different ways, but God showed me he can do more. And you'll look back and say, how did we make it? Anybody else got there last year? Like, how did I make it? God, you are real. So that's what we're going to encounter this year. And I'm looking forward to that this season, I should say. Amen. So I'm looking forward to that intentional an increase. Everything you do, I want you to measure it, because I want you to see that it's going to grow by 10%. Amen. I'll talk about that later. I'm getting off right here. If you are watching me right now and you want to start your year and know that you have a relationship with Christ, I like to invite you right now. Listen to me. Not because some of you, you've said the quote unquote sinner's prayer. But I am calling you to have a relationship this year, with God. And a relationship means there is a back and forth with you and God. I have three calls for you. Number one, if you need a pastor, I would love to be your pastor. Because you're going to need a pastor to help shepherd you through and to help you find the courses of your life in this season of your life. Number two, if you like to be a part of the body of Christ, which is probably one of the most important things you can ever do in your life. And number three, that you be filled with Holy Spirit. So let's start with number two. You never asked Jesus to be the Lord of your life, to be your Savior. Follow this prayer with me. Speak these words. Say, Heavenly Father, I know that I have sinned, and right now, I give my life to you. I know I need you. I cannot do this without you. I don't want to do this life without you. So today, I give my life to you. Today, I begin to learn how to love you. Thank you for waiting for me. Thank you for helping me become aware of you. I want to be saved. I want to be whole. Amen. You pray that prayer, you are a part of the body of Christ. Welcome. Amen. Now to do this, you need the gift of the whole purpose of what Christ died on the cross for. And that was one of the main reasons, is that you can hear or have a piece of God in you, God's Spirit, Holy Spirit. Pray this prayer after me. Say, Father, this year, I want to hear you. I want to hear your voice. I want your Spirit to be in me. I want to hear your Spirit this year. I want to sense your Spirit this year more than I did last year. So I want my relationship with you, Lord, to grow this year. So help me nourish your Spirit on the inside of me. Help me not to grieve you living in me, because greater are you that is in me than the Spirit that lives in the world. I know there are two spirits, and this year I want Holy Spirit to speak louder than the spirit of the world. Amen. Yeah, now you need a pastor that's going to help you walk that out. I love to be a pastor. If you'd like to, just log on to World Conquerors Church if you're not already on there and say, I want to be a part of World Conquerors Church. I want him to be my pastor. If you're here and I've been around you, but you're like, you know what, I ain't been listening to him all these years, and you declare that you want a pastor, here to do that. Amen. So please log in, get all your information in, and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thank you for joining us. And until the next time, make sure that you take this one point that we gave until we meet again. As a matter of fact, check us out. We'll be doing some things Thursday, your Thursday Bible study online. So you can check that out. My wife should be with me, right? You'll be with me on Thursday. And so we'll be teaching there and other things that will be coming up as well. God bless you. And until the next time, be blessed.